Welcome back, Zero K fans, to Nanolays at Dawn. I remain your host, Shadow Fury 333, and we are going to be moving on to a game between Orphelius and Andrew Y2K on Red Comet. This map should be very familiar to anyone who's played this game, because it is a super popular map, and Andrew Y2K going for a rather unpopular strategy on this map, namely the Cloaky Bot Factory, while on the other hand, Orphelius going for a less unpopular, actually relatively normal, hovercraft strategy. Both players starting out relatively aggressive, Andrew Y2K just going for a bit of scouting, whereas Orphelius going for a couple daggers, one for defense, one for offense. So Andrew Y2K a little more confident they can hold off in the meantime. Although against daggers, that will be a little bit challenging. Just due to the speed difference between the glaive and the dagger. It's gonna make it a lot harder to get rid of, but at the same time, it may actually... Actually, I don't know. I don't know why you're going for Cloaky Bot on this map. I can't really spin this positively. This map does not work especially well for bots. It works a bit better for bots than, say, Comet Catcher. Like, it's not the worst big flat map for bots, but big flat maps typically don't work well for bots. That's kind of a rule of thumb. They just don't. So at this point, Andrew Y2K, I don't really understand what they're planning on doing. Like, what reason they have for going Cloaky, except maybe familiarity, but honestly, this map is one you'd go for light vehicles on. If you don't know what to do, light vehicles on this map is pretty much the way to go. Hovercraft is not a bad idea, but hovercraft is also a bit tricky. You have to basically be trying to plan out for either being like Golda in your use of daggers, although, man, when was the last time Golda played this game? Or you have to be basically going for scalpels. You're shooting for scalpels, shooting for halberds, maybe shooting for maces. Daggers can be useful for harassment, but after that, they're not super useful. They're rather tricky to use, to be more precise. They're useful, but their main strength is their line splash. However, given how often units move in 0K, line splash is more useful when you're dealing with heavier units, at which point the daggers are also getting torn to shreds by the fact that they're heavier units. Well, slower units, at least. I suppose Rockos would fall to daggers pretty quickly. But glaives? I'm not sure. Really, the dagger speed is probably the main thing given the daggers an edge in that fight. But Orphelius not building up too much. They want to get their economy. They're not building up much military at the moment. Andrew Y2K, on the other hand, really focusing on both. Kind of split between both. But they kind of have to be. It's really more defense on their part because what can they do? I mean, if they try to attack, Orphelius will just tear them to shreds with hit and run attacks. And even on defense, there's still hit and run attacks that can come in. I mean, heck, even as you can see, getting rid of one dagger is a problem, although an attack to the northeast attempted by Andrew Y2K did not go very well. So Andrew Y2K right now is not in a position they'd like to be, while Orphelius is in a wonderful position for them, although that being said, Andrew Y2K is not doing too bad for their own economy. It's just, it will be harder and harder as the game progresses. I mean, once Andrew takes the northwest side, that'll kind of be it. While Orphelius can take the southeast side and take their entire east side, and that's not going to be too hard. Like, they won't have a hard time defending that. And already Orphelius into the halberds, they want to go for breaking these defenses. Andrew Y2K is starting to build up a bit of a defense line. Not a huge defense line, mind you, just a small defense line, a couple defenders here and there. Nothing so far planned other than that. And Orphelius with a few defenders of their own, but really going to be focusing on defense breakage. And also making sure no harassment happens to the northwest, northeast rather. Very good option. People don't do this enough, building solar plants. That's also this particular arrangement where you have this echelon position. It's wonderful because then units think they can go in and they start to go in and then they get trapped and have to turn around and your units might be in, well, they have more time to basically go in and stop the opponent's units. I always recommend doing that. I don't always see it, but I always recommend doing it. I always try to do it myself when I have the chance. Now, Orphelius is only doing it to the north, not doing it to the south. It looks like Andrew Y2K really is focused on defenses. The halberd's not a bad idea, but I think we might need more heavy firepower. Like, penetrators are a little much at this point. But maybe not. Maybe a penetrator would be enough. Orphelius does have a slight economic advantage, though it's more a matter of no caretakers. Where are the caretakers? On the other hand, Andrew Y2K with a couple of conjurers right next to the factory. So Andrew doesn't have any concerns. Orphelius, on the other hand, they're gonna have to worry about that. I mean, their commander's been idle over to the north as well. And there we go. There are the caretakers being built up. Not the most efficient way of going about it, but still there. And nice counterattack coming in here. As Orphelius goes for the assault, Andrew Y2K pushing their own attack. What does Andrew Y2K know? I mean, they gotta have... Oops. Gotta have something here. I mean, no, that's Orphelius' side. Andrew Y2K, what do they know? Ah, they have radar. That's what they knew. Nicely done. Good use of radar knowledge. Because really, that was a well-timed attack. It did not really do much. It got rid of some of the defenses, though. It pushed Andrew Y2K just that little bit further forward. And when they're playing bots, they're playing the slow side. They're playing the defensive side. Even as cloaky bots, they need to have their territory secure. They can't leave it open to flanks, and they need to basically kind of slowly push. Or Orphelius, on the other hand, they have the freedom to go around, harass, flank, go around the sides, which is flanking, so that was redundant. But they can do all that stuff because they have the speed to do it. Andrew does not have that speed. They do not have an easy way of getting around in order to just manage all the stuff on the map. They have to be slow and steady about it. They have to do a hard push. Have to get defenses up, have to make sure that the daggers can't easily get through anything. And any openings they get from the daggers going out of position, they have to force Orphelius to respect their forces. Like, they have to force Orphelius to respect the fact that the daggers cannot move out of position, otherwise Andrew will come in and just wreck face. Because it'll be open. And Andrew will know it's open, but at this point, Orphelius, not even really switching over to scalpels. They have a few scalpels, but they aren't building them that regularly, and... Oh, wait, that's... Yeah. I think the game crashed. Yeah, the game crashed, because I hit 3 while I was out of... The next stable count comes soon enough. There is a stable fix for this, but the last version stable was like a month and a half ago. I don't even know when it was. It was a long time ago, and that got fixed along with loads of other stuff. Yeah, it was March 13th, so about a month ago. So yeah, because there's a bug I totally forgot about, where if you have line of sight and you're trying to line of sight into... basically into your opponent, it's like, or sorry, into 3 or into player that doesn't exist, it won't work. I don't know how far we were. Just gonna get back to wherever we were. Sorry about that. I forgot that bug was still a thing, and I had to be careful when it came to trying to figure out player visibility. Or vision, rather. Be up in a moment. I might as well just show you guys what's the speed up version. Hey, so yeah, we saw all this stuff up to basically Andrew probably taking out, what are they taking out? Okay, this was the attack, roughly the point I think where we were. Yeah, it's about the point where we were. I wanted to see the factory. Oh boy, I didn't waste too much time, I suppose, but still, that was annoying. That was an annoying 20 seconds. Hopefully that doesn't happen again. So yeah, scalpels, a few of them are coming in. Oh no, Orphelius has switched wholeheartedly to scalpels now. So the daggers are going to go around to harass, but the scalpels are enough for Andrew to now have to respect Orphelius. Orphelius isn't going to leave that open. And at the same time, Andrew did put some defenses up over to the north, but not enough. Really, that's one Lotus on, what, 8 daggers? 9 daggers? 7, no, 8 daggers. Yeah, that's not great. So yeah, that is really not the place they'd want it to be. Bunch of warriors coming in. But against the scalpels, that's basically not the counter. And on the other hand though, Andrew Y2K already way ahead of the curve with the napalm. I should have pointed that out, but the game kind of crashed around the point I noticed the phoenixes were coming in. But yeah, phoenixes. Good counter for the scalpels. That once again leaves Orphelius open. And Andrew Y2K taking full advantage of that. The daggers are way out of position. They didn't even manage to do much. They did get rid of the Lotus here, but at great cost, really. That's a lot of units dead. That was 4 daggers dead. So that didn't work out as well as they would have liked. The Halberd buying time for the Penetrator to deal some damage, but even then, that's not great. At this point, the south side locked out. The north side, not so much. A Brave Warrior coming in here. It's going to die in a couple seconds, but... No, it's not! Able to get through... And Phoenix also able to deal some damage. This is a hero warrior right here. This warrior right... Oh, well, right as I go to look at it, gets killed by a dagger. But hey, that warrior did more than pretty much any other unit in Andrew Y2K's entire army. That was the MVP warrior right there. Man, it better have a good place in the great mechanic shop in the sky. At any rate, with that hero warrior dead, we do still have an army behind, and Andrew Y2K does have quite a lot of economy, despite basically only cutting the swath in here. They do have actually the point that they are expecting themselves. Where is their caretaker army? No, there's only one. One caretaker, they have a couple more... Well, it's mostly reclaimed from the looks of it. Yeah. Now, the Conjurer reclaiming over to the northwest. Not much else. So that's not going to work too well. And Andrew Y2K, well, pulling back a few things, but still, it's not really working out for Orphelius right now. The only thing Orphelius has is they have the production to deal with their economy, and even then, it's only just barely, but still, they have that. While Andrew Y2K just barely struggling to get the production they need to match their economy, so they aren't accessing. Unfortunately for Andrew Y2K, they did not have warriors in play when the daggers came up. So yeah, it's just units at the right time in the right place. That is being the problem, as is accessing on both sides. Both players having a hard time with the excess. But Andrew Y2K pretty much able to take most of the south side, because this wall is kind of stopping Orphelius from expanding further. Don't really have the north side, though. Orphelius is taking that gradually. Though Andrew Y2K could counterattack pretty easily, come to think of it. Wouldn't actually be that much to get in. These Roccos are actually going north, but I say they could, and they are, and they aren't. Are they? What are they doing? Okay, there we go. That's what I expected. Same time over to the south, we do have... Actually, never mind, back to the north. Defense push over to the northwest being a bit of a problem. Andrew Y2K wanting to make sure that their own defenses are still in a good position. I'm a bit surprised they haven't tried to take the south side, though. I don't think they realize the southeast has been totally walled off. Orphelius can't really push through that direction. And Scalables being scouted out. Nice Wyvern there. Mostly for the information. It did deal a bit of damage, but mostly the information. And of course, it's a Wyvern. It could get rid of pretty much anything here right now. In fact, the Commander is a nice, juicy target. Orphelius losing that would be a bit of a blow. Not a huge blow, but actually, come to think of it. One, two. No, they got plenty of... Well, the caretakers, yeah. Thinking mobile workers, but they have some around, so it's not a big deal. But at the same time, the Roccos did get rid of a few of the metal extractors, which is exactly what was needed. And now Andrew Y2K basically trapping these forces over in the northwest. Not totally trapping them, but it is going to be a bit of a hard... No, Orphelius is getting out of there. Orphelius knows there's no way those daggers are going to be able to last, so they're just going to move them out. Andrew... basically taking the midline. Bit of a territory advantage, honestly. Right now, Andrew Y2K in a good position. And once again, that penetrator just can't hit through the radar. It's missing the warrior outright. I mean, it went for it. It shot right past it. The warrior saw the beam over its shoulder, but once again, did not hit. So Orphelius right now, I mean, they're still kind of trying to hold on to the northwest. But they aren't going to be able to do so easily. And it looks like it's... Yeah, some defense is coming in here. Oh no, Andrew lost the Wyvern! Ouch. That's 2,000 metal right there. Right next to Orphelius's worker. That's a lot of reclaim Orphelius has. I mean, Andrew could deal with that probably. And it looks like they are... No, they're not going to. Going for the Strider Hub. Wanting to go for the direct assault. Don't really want to be hanging around trying to retake their northwest side. Just push up, get rid of it. But Orphelius right now, I mean, all these scalpels against all these Roccos, the warriors are not really helping Andrew. I think they think Orphelius is going to go for daggers. If they were, yeah, the warriors would be a great idea, but they're not. They're going instead for pure scalpel, so the warriors are kind of dead weight. Although I suppose they do tank shots, but it's not great. So Strider Hub coming in at the same time as Grizzly coming in for Orphelius. And Orphelius, did they have... No, they have just the Amphit plant and the Hovercraft factory. They'd be perfect if this map had water in it. But it doesn't. However, Hovercraft, like I said at the beginning of the game, it does have its place in this map. It's not... It's far from useless. It's just... It does require a particular strategy, and that strategy does involve the scalpels. Which can be a little hard to approach with. And now Andrew with their counter defense. They got the artillery up. They're not letting Orphelius get away with this defensive line. However, that's probably the worst timing given that the Grizzly's coming in here. Oh! Okay, Andrew apparently disconnected during the game proper, but it all worked out. It got paused properly. Are they realizing that the Grizzly's here? Okay, they are. They realize something's there at least. I think they realize the Grizzly's there. Yeah. So right now, bit of a desperate assault, but this is going to be suicide for Andrew Y2K. There's no way they can deal any meaningful damage here. They need to let Orphelius come out, and then once Orphelius has overextended themselves, then assault. And nice! There we go. There's the glaze that were needed to get rid of the northwest side. Finally broke that free of Orphelius' control. Like I said, Andrew Y2K pretty much had that. Everything here is dead. Was already dead. Now it's dead officially. Though this counter, this is what I mean. This is what Andrew Y2K needed to have done before they lost their entire army. Was let Orphelius walk out and then tear Orphelius' army apart when it's out of position, when it's overextended itself a little bit. Just get them overconfident. And it looks like counter assault, counter raid coming in here, which is not going to do much good. These glaives are going to hit the solar wall, maybe go around it. Maybe just try to bash right through it. To try to bash right through it, the Lotus is going to stop them. If they try to go around it, the Dagger is going to stop them. So those glaives have very little shot at doing anything, but might as well see what they're going to try to do. And it looks like, no, they actually go around the wall, so they do realize pathfinding-wise, there is a wall there that I cannot get through. Not trying to be tricky about it. So they scout out the wall, kill up a couple daggers, otherwise don't do much. At the same time, though, that's a lot of ducks. I would say, at the same time, though, that did get good information about what's over to the north. The problem being that Andrew doesn't have much of an army. We're seeing a similar situation to the last game with Spideplick and Don, where Andrew has the economic advantage, they have the territory advantage, and now they have the information advantage, but they don't have the military advantage because they kept losing units. It's actually one of the hardest parts about playing Cloakybot Factory. And a funnel up coming in. Wow, okay. Bit of a jump, but given the amount of money Andrew has, I guess it makes sense. But yeah, so with... Because Andrew lost so many units, Orphelius basically has a military advantage despite the economic disadvantage. Once again, this does come down to if Andrew can get rid of Orphelius' army, it's going to be easy for Andrew to rebuild. They'll rebuild faster. But getting rid of the army is the hard part. I mean, even some disarm... Okay, disarm coming in, not doing a bad job. But no follow-up. There's glaze right here, but they aren't following up. More disarm as well, so at least that'll keep things there for as long as it takes for the funnel web to arrive. But still, that's not a huge amount, especially with all the defenders here. I mean, that's something. It's not great. The glaives aren't moving in, the sharpshooter is moving in, but still, multi-prong attack over to the north as well. Orphelius should be able to break through this. I mean, after these stingers, that's about it. There's not much else. Andrew was pretty naked behind that. Like, behind that big wall, there wasn't much left. On the other hand, we do have a sniper, which will help with getting rid of defenses, I suppose, a little bit, but still not great. And the ducks in the funnel web, I think the funnel web at this point, having no drones, is basically its own death. Like, there's not much it's going to be able to do. And the soft AA of the ducks does mean the drones don't have much of an option, so really, that funnel web is probably the worst choice Andrew could have gone for. I mean, typically you see people going for Dante because they're really good at defending themselves and they don't need anything else, and they're relatively cheap. I mean, it's about the same cost as a funnel web, I suppose, but for the amount of setup a funnel web requires and the amount of support it requires, like, Andrew pretty much just lost the game right there. Their economic advantage is nowhere near big enough to make up for having essentially burned 4,500 metal. That's all there is to it. Orphelius now with the economic advantage, pretty much. Thanks to Reclaim. Probably able to push that. I mean, suicide attacks coming in from Andrew, not sure what they're trying to achieve, because at this point, there's like 14 rapiers, Grizzly on top of that, Orphelius' commander as well, and the Penetrator is... I think, still alive. So yeah, Andrew Y2K realizing there isn't really much hope. Gotta say, I really did question Cloakybot at the start, and I still question it at the end. Not sure really what the point of Cloakybot was. It didn't work. It worked pretty well, though. I gotta say, the defenses were used fairly well, and did expand nicely. It's just, I think that Strider choice was really the problem, because at that point, Andrew needed to break. They needed to break Orphelius' army in order to be able to really push any advantages they had, that is, that Andrew Y2K had, but they lost their Strider instead, which meant that Orphelius' advantage, it was about even at that point, and losing the Strider tipped the scales enough that Orphelius could go in with their larger army. Because Andrew Y2K, they had the smaller army. They had to break Orphelius' army, and if they could do that, then they'd have the advantage from there to be able to push in, and it would have been a bit of a slog because of all the defenders, but still probably push in and deal a fair amount of damage, hopefully getting through and breaking Orphelius, but unfortunately, they lost their main trump card. So yeah, that was that. The last game for tonight is going to be on... Where is that? There it is. The last game of tonight is going to be on Altair Crossing between Capricious and Spartacus. Oh yeah, North Chilean G pointing out, a few sides for raids would have been a good idea. That actually would have really justified the factory. Ticks as well. A few ticks thrown down where the scalpels were coming in. I mean, hell, even ticks thrown out as the scalpels were approaching, because the ticks would have been able to rush in, I think, fast enough that they would have gotten close enough to the scalpel that even in dying, they would have stunned out the scalpel. But they probably would have been hit, but they might have stunned out the scalpel in the process. But definitely if they'd been placed in ambush. They were lying in wait. But yeah, scythes and ticks would have been great. Scythes for going around, getting around the defenders entirely, and ticks for stopping the army. Like, the Thunderbird wasn't a bad idea, but there were too many defenders for that to really work. Ticks in advance, though. In advance, I emphasize. I mean, the army far enough ahead, that would have allowed the ticks to rush in, but as a general rule, no. Don't rush in ticks. Have them prepped. But yeah, if they'd had them prepped, that would have been good. But yeah, I feel like Andrew Y2K went for Cloaky because they're comfortable with them, because they're kind of a comfortable factory. I do that too, a lot. I totally understand that. I can totally see that's why they do it, but the thing with Cloakybot Factory is you kind of got to use its tools. That's one thing I've found. And of course, there's also the Eraser, so you can just cloak your entire army and push in. Which against scalpels is awesome, because the scalpels can't hit the army in advance. Actually, Penetrator, Scalpel, and Grizzly, that entire army is essentially countered by an Eraser, cloaking your army and stopping their range from having any effect. Anyhow, that was that. So like I said, next game is Altair Crossing between Capricious and Spartacus. That'll be up in a couple minutes, so stay tuned.